non-believer from your Bible.
Do you love me?
I love my wife.
I didn't ask in that way. You said you know better than me.
I love you as a human being, but you don't love yourself.
Yahya expressed that he loves me. I brought up the Quranic verse, Surah 5:31 and 32, that actually Allah doesn't like me. So
according
therefore,
to your Bible,
thank you for being much better than Allah.
Aside,
so that's the first point. Now, let's move on to the second point. I want to make it the second point. So I've got Islamic sources, which I'm a bit curious about what's happening. I am interpreting these Islamic sources as overnight, Muhammad is being raped. But I need you to help me to understand what it is saying, okay? If you want to see the Arabic, Arabic is here. I read the English and then follow up with me in case you fail to understand my pronunciation. Abdullah said, the messenger of Allah, remember what is my question? My question is this story explained, unpacking for us in any form or any shape that Muhammad is being raped, okay, overnight. Abdullah said, the messenger of Allah asked me to follow him. Abdullah said, so we ventured out until I got to such and such place. So the messenger laid out a plan for me. He said, stay in this place and do not leave it. Because if you leave it, you will be perished. And Abdullah said, so I was there. He said, so messenger of Allah went forward, a stone thrown away, or perhaps little further. Abdullah said, he mentioned a group of race of people wearing no clothes. Group of people are wearing no clothes, but I cannot see their private parts. Tall, having little flesh. He said, so they come and they proceed to ride the messenger of Allah. Naked people, whose private parts are not being seen yet, they are tall with little flesh, are proceeding to ride Muhammad. He said, and the messenger of Allah proceed to recite upon them. He said, and they proceed to come to me, encircle me, and intercept me. Abdullah said, so I was terrified of them with a great terror. He said, I sat down. So when the pillar of morning came, they proceed to leave. The messenger of Allah came heavy and in pain, or almost in pain, because of how much they had ridden him. Did you get so much this part, Yahya? Because that's the all you we needed to know. But I continue. He said, Muhammad said, I find myself heavy. So Abdullah said, messenger of Allah, put his head on my lap. Then the group came back wearing long white clothes with the messenger of Allah head dozed off. Abdullah said, I become terrified more. So then the first time, so they said to each other, this slave was given good. Or they said, his eyes were asleep, but his heart is awake. He said, then they said to each other, come, let us give him an example. Or they said to each other, give him an example, and we interpreted it. We give it, and we interpret it. So they said to each other, he is like a master who built a fortified building. Then he sent food to some people, whoever did not eat his food, or he said, did not follow him. He tortured him and severed torture. He said, the master is the lord of the worlds. Whereas the building is Islam and the food is paradise, an inviter, whoever follows him would be in paradise. Or they said, whoever does not follow him will be tortured. Then the messenger of Allah woke up and said, what did you see, son of mother of Abdul? Abdullah said, I saw so and so. The prophet replied, there are some of the angels. And then he said, they are the angels as Allah wills, or as Allah wills. So the part I am curious about is what happened to Muhammad overnight, okay? I read it to you. beings which Muhammad later identifies as an angel, who is wearing no clothes, rides on Muhammad all night, and then morning Muhammad is in pain. What happened to Muhammad?
Is there any verse of the Quran from all this what you wrote?
This is from the Islamic tradition, Ahmed ibn Hanbal.
Ahmed
ibn
Hanbal, can you tell me?
Page 332, 333, 334.
When Ahmed ibn Hanbal came and wrote this?
So let me just clarify. You don't take anything outside of the Quran, correct?
I take, but...
So what is your reasoning that you are questioning Ibn Hanbal?
Was that to do with God's love or God's hate?
No, I am asking, what is your...
Sit in front of the camera and read whatever you want to read and make it as instead of, this is, for me, this is garbage.
Okay.
And your name is...
That's fine. This Hatun is garbage.
Trash. It should be Hatun Trash. Because the trash you're bringing in, I really don't understand the trash. And when you say this is Islamic scholar, what's this trash?
So that's fine. So now...
Fine, it's fine, yeah.
Rest in peace, Ibn Hanbal. He is trash, he is rubbish. We moved on from him. Let's go to Sahih Bukhari.
Here's the shouter, he's here.
Sahih Bukhari.
As I said, kill no believer according, according to your Bible.
Yahya, you choose to.
Check it at home. Chronicles.
I don't need it.
15, 12, 13.
Two
Chronicles.
What is that?
Chronicles.
I don't know what is that, Yahya.
This is in your Bible.
I don't know. I don't know what is that.
15, 12, 13.
I don't know what is that, Yahya. So figure out what is that. So let me ask you. Let me ask you as well. Since you identified Ibn Hanbal as trash, I want you to answer some
13,
question from Sahih Bukhari.
Chapter 13, verse number 7 and 12.
Do you take Sahih Bukhari, Yahya?
Bukhari came 195 even after the Prophet.
Okay,
don't you rely on the Quran?
Okay.
Because
Here's the problem. I am struggling to figure out which Quran I should rely on.
Okay. What?
Can you tell me?
Check with Hafiz. I guess I like Hafiz.
Oh, you like